Hello everyone. So this video is basically for dental students, and here I'm going to start with microbiology. And today's topic is structure and function of immune system. What is immune system? We all must actually know what is immune system all about. So it is a complex network of cells, tissues and organs that work together to defend against infection. Here, under immune system, we have to talk about lymphoreticular system because this is the system which is responsible for immune response. It consists of lymphoid system and reticuloendothelial system. Lymphoid system, it consists of lymphocytes, plasma cells, and reticuloendothelial system, it consists of phagocyte cells. The lymphoid system. Now, the lymphoid system consists of lymphoid cells and lymphoid organs. Lymphoid cells consist of lymphocytes and plasma cells, whereas lymphoid organs, two types of lymphoid organs we have. That is, first is central, or you can say primary lymphoid organs, and the second one is peripheral or secondary lymphoid organs. Under central lymphoid organs, you can see the examples like thymus, or bone marrow in mammals, etc. And under peripheral lymphoid organs, it can be spleen, lymph node, etc. Types of immune response. A specific immune response to an antigen is of two types. The first type is humoral or antibody mediated immunity, and second one is cell mediated immunity. So HMI is basically mediated by antibodies which are produced by plasma cells, and cell-mediated immunity is mediated by sensitized lymphocytes. Central lymphoid organs are those in which precursor lymphocytes proliferate, develop and become immunologically competent. And after, you know, becoming this immunologically competent, after gaining these capabilities, lymphocytes migrate to peripheral lymphoid organs, and there occurs an immune response when exposed to antigens. Cells of lymphoreticular system. Basically, these cells consist of two types of cells are there. One is your structural cells and the other is immunologically competent cells. Under structural cells comes reticulum cells, endothelial cells and fibroblasts. And under immunologically competent cells comes lymphocytes, plasma cells and macrophages. So here you can see the percentage of the, you know, in circulating blood, T lymphocytes are about 70% and B lymphocytes about 20%, and null cells are about 10%. So lymphocytes developed in central lymphoid organs, they become immunologically competent cells. So here comes the functions of lymphoreticular system. So three main functions that we are going to talk about in this slide are recognition of antigens, very important, storage of immunological memory, and immune response to antigen. So nature of any immune response is basically depends on the type of cell which is stimulated by antigen. So if like T cells are stimulated, they're going to produce certain lymphokines and induce cell mediated immunity, whereas stimulated B cells divide and transform into plasma cells, which further synthesize antibodies and induce the HMI. Now, difference between T lymphocytes and B lymphocytes. So, in short, if I talk about, so T lymphocytes, T cells, you know, bind to sheep erythrocyte, they form RBC rosette, while the B lymphocytes are going to form EAC rosette, means erythrocyte amoreceptors complement. So, under T lymphocytes, they have thymus-specific antigens on the surface. And B lymphocytes do not have that. Then T lymphocytes have CD3 receptors on surface, while B lymphocytes do not have that. And T lymphocytes, they have T cell receptors, and B lymphocytes, they have immunoglobulins on surface and surface receptor for Fc fragment of IgG. Now, in T lymphocytes, blast transformation of T lymphocytes, it occurs with mitogens like PHA or Concervin A. Whereas blast transformation in B lymphocytes, it occurs with bacterial endotoxin. B cells have numerous microvilli on surface. Now, if I talk about T lymphocytes, so here you can see the types of T lymphocytes. First is regulatory T lymphocytes. Under regulatory T lymphocytes, we have T helper CD4 cells and T suppressor CD8 cells. Then we have the second one, that is effector T cells. Under this comes your cytotoxic T cells and delayed type hypersensitivity cells. So surface antigen on T cell can be detected by monoclonal antibodies. These thymic antigens are designed as CD. CD, the full form of CD, is cluster of differentiation. So this was all about lymphocytes. Then we have regulatory T cells. Now you can see the types of T cells that we have. Regulatory T cells and effector T cells. So in short, if I tell you about regulatory T cells and effector cells, so regulatory T cells, as I told you in the previous slide, it was of two types, T helper cells and suppressor cells. So T helper cells, they help the B lymphocytes to produce immunoglobulins, and they are about 63%. And suppressor cells or CD8, these are going to block the response by their action on T helper cells. So these are 35%. If there is activity of helper cells, if that activity is over, it is increased, or decreased suppressor cell activity is there, then it leads to autoimmunity. And if there is decreased helper cell activity or increased suppressor cell activity, it results in immunodeficiency. Now, if I talk about effector cells, so these are of two types, cytotoxic T cells and delayed type hypersensitivity cells. So in cytotoxic T cells, they can lyse specified target cells whose surface antigens are recognized by them. So example, you can see virally infected cells or tumors. So they have membrane glycoprotein CD8. Okay. So under delayed type hypersensitivity cells, these cells are responsible for delayed type 4 hypersensitivity. As we have, a separate chapter about hypersensitivity, it is a very important topic. So I hope that you all are acknowledged about type 4 hypersensitivity. And so they have CD4 markers as in T helper cells. Then we talk about null cells. This is small proportion of lymphocytes which are neither T cells nor B cells. So we call it as null cells. Under null cells, these are of three types basically: killer cells, natural killer cell, and lymphokine activated cells. Here, if I talk about K cells, now these are going to, on their surface, they have a receptor for Fc proportion of IgG. They kill the target cells sensitized with IgG antibodies. And the one important thing, that no complement is required for kill in K cells. K cells are responsible for antibody dependent cell mediated cytotoxicity. Then comes natural killer cells. Natural killer cells, their action is independent of antibody. Okay, no sensitization by prior antigenic contact. You know, no sensitization is required. And they are going to play very important role in antiviral and anti-tumor immunity. Third one is lymphokine activated killer cells. So these are, you know, natural killer cells treated with interleukin 2, which are cytotoxic to tumor cells without affecting the normal cells. Now, if I talk about B lymphocytes and plasma cells. So here, B lymphocytes, you know, these are stimulated by antigen. And if they are stimulated by antigen, then they undergo blast transformation to become plasma cells. Then you have a plasma cell can synthesize an antibody of single specificity of any single immunoglobulin. Example, it can be IgG, it can be IgM, or it can be IgA. Then exception is plasma cell synthesizing IgM. Initially it is synthesizing IgM, but later it switch over to IgG production. So this is an exception. Then we talk about phagocytic cells. Phagocytic cells, these are mononuclear macrophages and the polymorphonuclear macrophages. So under phagocytic cells, we are going to study about macrophages first. So macrophages, the blood macrophage monocytes are largest lymphoid cells present in peripheral blood. So there are, you know, three functions of macrophages. First is phagocytosis, and second one is specific immune response. You know, under this, the function is basically they trap and process the bacterial antigen and present them in optimal concentration to lymphocytes for induction of specific immune response. Now, activated macrophages, they are going to secrete IL-1, which induce T cells to release IL-2. By IL-1 and IL-2, I mean interleukin-1, interleukin-2. So this interleukin-2, which is released by T cells, this is going to facilitate the T cell activation. It's going to activate the T lymphocytes, and thus this is going to initiate cell-mediated immunity. Then we can see anti-tumor activity and graft rejection. So activated macrophages are not antigen specific. Okay, so they secrete a number of biologically active substances, interleukin. Okay, so tumor necrosis factor and colony stimulating factor. They become armed when stimulated by cytophilic antibodies. You know, wherever these anti-tumor, you know, activity and graft rejection, in this, whenever they they become armed when they are stimulated by cytophilic antibodies and certain lymphokines. So these armed macrophages are very important in anti-tumor activity and graft rejection. Here I'm going to talk about secondly macrophages. Okay, so macrophages they contain polymorphonuclear leukocytes. Okay, under which you can see neutrophils, eosinophils, and basophils. So neutrophils, if I talk about, they have non-specific phagocytic property, and they have very important role. They play a very important role in acute inflammation. Then we have eosinophils. I think we all are very much acknowledged about these neutrophils, eosinophils, and basophils. So, you know, a little about this is in eosinophils, less phagocytic than neutrophils. So these are less phagocytic than neutrophils. These are found in large number in allergic inflammation and parasitic infections. Basophils, these are present in blood and tissues. Now, degranulation of mast cells release their pharmacologically active agents like, you know, serotonin, heparin, histamine, etc., resulting in anaphylaxis and allergy. Then we have dendritic cells. also, see, although macrophages are major antigen presenting cells, no doubt, but the dendritic cells, they also perform this function. So thank you so much guys for watching the video, and do like, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you so much.